One of the points that I always check when doing a track check for mastering is the point color. And what I actually mean with color is actually making your own fingerprint in terms of sound coloration and sound saturation and stuff. So in some music productions, it's really cool to have a bit of color on your master bus. And there are several ways to do that. For instance, tape, you know, driving pretty loud through something analog. The FabFilter Saturn is a good suggestion, but that one is a bit complicated. And there are many more options, and the option that I want to explore today is the RC20 Retro Color from XLN Audio. Bit difficult name. So, let's find out if this thing is snake oil or not. So the RC20, well, the first thing we see on their website is your sound in color. So that's exactly what I'm talking about, color. It sells for €79.95, which is pretty competitive, but still, it's a lot of money if you think about the fact that it's only ones and zeros. But on the other hand, they also have to be made in a certain pattern for it to work. And that's a bit of a hassle. It adds life and texture inspired by classic gear. Great on drums, guitars, bass, and full mixes. That's what we're going to test. Full mixes of Sandstorm. And the Flux Engine adds warm analog style fluctuations. The Flux Engine. Like the Flux Capacitor, but then the engine. So that's in that was in the front of the DeLorean. Or no, it had the engine in the back. Creative effect plugin that adds life and texture to any recording. It easily recreates the warm, cozy feeling of vintage recording equipment, but also works perfectly in any modern production setting. So it's got 6 unique modules. It can replicate everything from vinyl records to VHS machines, noise adding, that's always interesting, wobble and dropouts, raw distortion, crunchy bit reduction, grits to bass and drums. The space and chorus effects will make your guitar sing like never before, and the filtering effect fits right into the most modern club track. Okay, Flux Engine, so that's like, I think, some kind of an LFO. That makes instability and fluctuations throughout it or something. And a magnitude slider. That controls the intensity of all processing. I think it should be something like a dry wet switch or something, or like presets. Yeah, of course, presets. It runs on all systems, starting from macOS 10.7, and it also runs on Windows, but who's interested in that? Let's run some Sandstorm through it. Through it. All right, so this is what the plugin looks like by default. And it's got a pretty mixture of a cool interface and classic buttons, but let's not complain about that right now, because in the end you need buttons. And if we look at the Pro-Q, they also have round buttons, because without buttons or knobs you cannot do anything. So let's not complain about that. We've got noise, we've got wobble, distortion, we've got digital, it's turned off right now, we've got space, and we've got magnetic. Bit irritating that it also removes the controls when you turn it off. That's a bit confusing, maybe. For me it is, but I'm a bit of a weird guy, but you guys already knew that. So noise, wobble, distortion. Let's run through them one by one so we can hear what they are doing. So noise should be really simple. Let's press play. Sounds pretty random also. Oh, different. That's a lot of different types. A lot of different types of noise. So one thing that is irritating me about the noise feature is it's actually pretty random, but it only works when playing back. Why is this irritating me? So I had a few comments about me complaining about why do you need noise in a plugin. I still don't really get it. Some people said, well, we like to have some noise on the background when we're doing a writing session or when we're like making music, because it's inspiring. And I can understand that, but this doesn't do that. So it can add color, like vinyl, some cozy vinyl stuff to your music, which is nice. but it can only layer it on top of the sound. You cannot, like, it doesn't want to continuously output it. Could be nice to have like a button like enable it, just enable it. All right, noise, pretty straightforward. Wobble. Wobble. Interesting. So this is such a setting to either keep low in volume, so just have it a bit like you almost can't hear it, or automating, like building up to something and have it on a certain sound. Oh, you can, yeah, okay. So I would really use it at like 1% or something. Just there, and it really triggers your ear to keep on listening. It's psychoacoustics. All right, distortion. More. Oh, that's tube distortion. That's iron distortion. Oh. Ah. Star Wars. Ah, this is speaker distortion. And tube, okay. Again, a lot of options. And flux. Oh. Yeah, it becomes more random. Really, how should they have done that? Like, random doesn't exist in a computer, but like almost random does, so. Interesting, and what is this? Ah! Oh, so this is actually something that I really like from Saturn. Like, in the Saturn from FabFilter, you can really focus your effect on a certain band of the music. So, right now it's on the lows, but not on the rest. So the clap and everything is like pretty dry. That's cool. That's really cool. Again, this is something that I would do like a tiny bit, but I would actually choose to have something from my own collection. Digital! That's something you cannot do analog, because analog isn't digital. That goes from like a bit to completely fucking up the sound. Interesting. So let's also turn up the flux on this one. Interesting. What does this do? Oh, so this cuts the complete sound. I made a new fat beat! This is a new music style. It's from a different universe. It's not even from a different planet, it's like from a different time continuum. I can listen to this the whole day. Alright, space! Magnetic, next one. Interesting. So let's slam them all together and see what comes out of it. Yeah, okay, but let's turn down the digital thing. You can really use this thing what it's meant for, and that's actually coloring your music production, as you can hear by combining all these things, like a tiny bit of each thing, you can completely change not only the color, but actually the feel of a track. If you do it correctly, then the color you're giving to the track actually is already supporting the original feel of the track, like the intended feel of the musicians, and you're just adding it, like making it a bit more extreme. That's actually what you want to do with these type of plugins. But there's another feature in this plugin that's really interesting, which is not really listed on their website, and that is what I already said, automating things like digital or wobble, most of the times in dance productions, but I'm also seeing this a lot in pop productions and even in rock productions, like automating it upwards towards something, a chorus or a drop or whatever. And that's something where this plugin, if you ask me, it's also really powerful. Go check out the Retro Color RC20 from XLN Audio. It sells for 80 euros. I don't know what the US dollar price is because they aren't, it's not there. I would say go check it out. You can try a free trial. It's a bit difficult to install it because they have like a download manager and stuff and a lot of but you can try it out yourself and take your own conclusions. Is this thing snake oil? Definitely not. It really delivers what it says it delivers. However, I would still prefer to use my own analog equipment instead of the tube stuff in here, because I think that I can still make a bit more dimension into the sound with my equipment, but that's a personal thing. So with that being said, thanks for watching this video. If you made it till the end, let me know by giving me a thumbs up. Leave a comment below with suggestions for future snake oil episode IDs stuff. Leave it below. And make sure to check out my Patreon campaign to support me by pledging a bit or maybe just checking it out. You will get behind the scenes look and early access to my content. And if you want to support me in a different way than Patreon, you can always support me by just watching another video over here. Thanks a lot for watching this one. Don't forget to subscribe. I'll see you guys again in the next video. Bye bye.